let's have a closer look at the tool options. If I click on the icon at the left of Dynamics, I see a list with options. Let's select Velocity Tapering. What Velocity Tapering does is it decreases the size and opacity of my brush when I move the mouse faster. Under Dynamics, there is an option Apply Jitter. Jitter will spread the brush randomly. Increasing amount will lead to a larger area in which the spreading takes place. I will set jitter to about 4 by dragging at the bottom of the amount bar. The next dynamic I would like to show you is speed size opacity. To show this dynamic, I will search for a brush I have downloaded, named Birds Flying 11. At the end of this lecture, I will show you how to download these three brushes. To search by name, I click on the brush thumbnail and select View as List at the bottom. To quickly go through the list, I drag the scroll bar. When I'm close to my destination, I can further scroll with my scroll wheel. I select Birds Flying 11. I will press the X key to paint blackbirds. I alt scroll to set the size to 150 and I will increase jitter to about 15. We can see that speed size opacity follows the direction of the mouse. It also decreases the size of the brush when I move the mouse faster. The next dynamic I would like to show you is Dynamics Random. I will choose another downloaded brush named Bubble Brushes by Hawksmont 3. I will press X to paint with white. For my next brush, I will create a white background. To fill the layer with white, I drag the foreground, which is white now, on the canvas. This way of filling is Gimp only. I can't do this in Photoshop. The Photoshop way of filling can be found under Edit, Fill with Foreground Color. The shortcut for this is Alt Backspace. I press X to set the foreground color to black. Let's use a colored brush. To choose a color, I click on the foreground color. The Change Foreground Color window opens. I drag the red slider. I can also scroll. I click on OK. I will make a grungy effect. In the tool options, I will select a GIMP brush, called Acrylic 5. The default GIMP brushes are at the bottom. I make the brush size a bit bigger. And I will disable jitter. To fill the layer with white again, I will now fill with the background color. I go to Edit, Fill with Background Color. The shortcut for this is Ctrl Backspace. When I choose Perspective, I can make crunchy strokes. With Fade Tapering, the brush fades in or out. Right now it fades in. If I click on Dynamics Options, I can reverse the fading direction. I will increase the fade length a bit. Now the brush fades out. To download free brushes, you can do a Google search for GIMP free brushes. There are several websites you can go to. I downloaded my brushes from deviantart.com. I click on the Browse tab and in the search box I type GIMP brushes. At the top left, you can sort on popular, all-time, newest, etc. If I scroll to the bottom, I can click on Show More. When you find a brush pack you like, you can click on it. At the right, you can see a download button. After downloading, scan the file with your antivirus and unzip the file. I go to the .gimp 2.8 folder where I've placed the plugins and open the brushes folder. I place the brushes in this folder. In GIMP, I go to the brushes panel and click at the bottom right on the Refresh Brushes icon. The new brushes are now ready to use. In the next lecture, we will look at how to use a tablet.